want you to pay with that number.
Oh my David. Do you want me to pay?
No.
Folks, and good night, and welcome to our live show here in the beautiful middle Sackville at the Drake's Residence. And we have some nice numbers lined up tonight, some requests for anniversaries and some birthdays and whatever the occasion might be, folks. And so what we're going to do, we're going to just wait till we get quite a few anniversaries and quite a few birthdays, and then we're going to lump them into one and do a particular number for them all, and also take requests too as well. Yeah, I gotta kind of change all the old carbon to the computer. Do a number now, folks, I haven't done for quite a while, called A Tribute to the Lady Anderson, and that's a number that was composed by singer-songwriter Mr. Bud Damage. And when the doing all these pinnacle ships, you come from port to port, and like the Christmas Seal and Lady Anderson, and used to see if everyone was medically fit. Seal, and I know in the other parts of Newfoundland, Labrador, Lady Anderson, and these ships used to come by and see if it was medically fit and get the scratches, if they were red or something, you had to go aboard and get the chest x-ray, and whatever the case may be. But anyway, a great, great song there is composed by singer-songwriter Mr. Bud Damage, and a tribute to Lady Anderson. Okay, folks. Mm-hmm. Okay, folks, I'm doing a number now called The Hands You're Holding Now. And we'd like to dedicate this number to Lucille Morrissey. Lucille, I'd like to hear this number and called The Hands You're Holding Now. Beautiful number indeed, folks. Facebook friends in tonight, and glad you're tuning in. And we have a beautiful day. We had a beautiful day here in Little Sackville, Nova Scotia, and speaks for a great weekend, and also for the for Halloween too as well. So that's great for the little kids. And fantastic. Okay, this is there.
Is that how I chose Steve and Daphne from Ottawa?
Yep. I'd like to give a special shout out to Steve and Daphne in beautiful Ottawa. How are you doing, guys? And glad you're tuning in. Was it?
Anniversary today.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, later.
I'd like to wish Daphne and Steve a happy anniversary, guys, and wishing nothing but the very, very best. So we're going to get a nice, appropriate number lined up for you fine folks. And on a beautiful anniversary to you and Steve and Daphne. And thanks for tuning in too as well, guys. Thank you, Lou. There's a number now called the Harry Ebbs Medley.
Rich Vincent says, don't get mad at me. He said, turn your drums down a little.
Who's that?
Rich.
Or drums?
Drums.
Or drums. Hey, I'd like to say hello to our good buddy Rich and his wonderful wife Michelle. How you doing, Rich, buddy? And glad you guys are tuning in tonight. And I'm going to try a little number after you. You're always doing a great job with Little Boats Newfoundland. And I wish you were here to do the talking, okay, on Little Boats Newfoundland. But you always do a super job with that number. Anyway, in the meantime, hope you start tuning in. But I'm hoping on getting that one on for sure. But we're going to do a number now called In My Father's House. In My Father's House. Okay. cottage is falling down. I dry my eyes as I fondly remember days of long ago when I was young. We were poor, but we were rich in love. No TV, but music there were plenty of. And my mother hummed her melodies, and we all sang along. In my father's house, now comes the time when I am older. My own children are reared and gone. I wonder then, will we fondly remember days of long ago when I was young. In my father's house, his smile would greet you at the door. A friendly word, your travelers then were welcome for. And at night time, they were trembling, like steak held 12 or 1. In my father's house, when I was young, the years have passed, and the times are changing. The rambling house is almost gone. I still hear the laughter of children, just like long ago when I was young. In my father's house, we were poor, but we were rich in love. No TV, but good times there were plenty of. And we made the best of what we had. We sang a happy song in my father's house when I was young. In my father's house when I was young. Number there, folks, that was composed by John McAvoy, and in my father's house. You know what? That song here is a song that all of us can identify with. You know, we all remember when we were sitting around the table and growing up in the midst of our wonderful parents, and can't beat that at all, folks. Beautiful memories indeed. And as a matter of fact, that song we dedicated to Ann Marie Brushett. That's for you, Ann, in my father's house. And, anyway, glad you're tuning in here. And thanks a lot to it, Dad. It's fantastic.
That's Johnny McAvoy, is it?
Yeah, that's what I said, Johnny McAvoy.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Get there, buddy. Awkward. Wait
for
that, Natalie.
No wonder.
No wonder, what do you mean?
Say hi to Carol and Eugene. Do you want great foggy day? No.
Carol and Eugene?
Yep.
Carol and Eugene, how you doing, guys? Very foggy day. Yeah, we'll get to that one, Carol and Eugene. And thanks for tuning in, guys. Really appreciate that. I'm going to get your number for you momentarily. Okay, let's see if we can get Yep.
You know Davy Jones?
Davy Jones, yeah, you know Davy Jones, buddy. You see, I'm playing the accordion. He's a great accordion player and entertaining some wonderful folks too, the seniors, and he does a great, great job, plays in the homes and that, and plays a great accordion. And Davy, thanks for tuning in, buddy, and you keep up the great work you're doing. You're a fantastic accordion player. And keep up the good stuff, and you're doing it for a good cause, for sure. I'm going to do a number now and dedicate that number to Davy and all his wife and his family and all his friends, sweet forget-me-not. And also we have a special dedication to, as well, to Paul White. How you doing, Paul? Thanks for tuning in tonight, buddy. Here's the Indy Coffee Conversation called Sweet Forget-me-not.
Forget me now.
forgive me, son. Please forgive me not, folks. And that's a lovely, lovely love song there. And we'll do some. I don't know why she's losing power, huh?
Say hi to Kirk.
And I'd like to give a shout out to a fine musician and a good friend, Mr. Kirk Feilander. How you doing, Kirk, buddy? And I wish you the very, very best, pal. And thanks for the CD, too, buddy. Just great. And really enjoying it, too, as well.
Foxtrap.
Yep. Kirk lived on the outskirts of St. John's in beautiful Foxtrap.
Hello, sister.
And send hello to Vina's sister Anita on the rock. Hi, Anita.
Are you ready to dance?
Here's a number called Love is Strong. Means, okay?
That's French. This poor old man here is in the hospital listening to you in Carbonier.
Okay.
Say hi to him. After?
Yeah. What do you say this?
Henry Keeby.
Henry Keeby? Okay.
In yeah. Carbonier Hospital, he's listening to you.
And we'd like to give a shout out to Henry Keeping in the Carbonair Hospital. And Henry, buddy, we're wishing you the very, very best, pal. And thanks for reaching out, too, as well. And take care of yourself and wishing you and your family the very, very best, buddy. So, going to do a number now that we have a special request for a call. Play me the Waltz of the Angels. And we'll do that number. I'd like to dedicate number to you, Henry, buddy. And wishing you a speedy recovery, too, pal. Thank you very much. And also, we'd like to do this one for Viola Greening. Viola, I want to hear this one too as well, called Play Me the Waltz of the Angels. Okay, now what key is that?
E.
Okay.
Let's hear
smiling at me and said,
If there's some place that he'd rather be, I would say, sir, I pray some before you. Something special that you'd like to hear. My sister-in-law, Mary. How you doing, Mary? Welcome in, Doc. Just great here.
Okay. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay, folks, right now I'd like to dedicate this number to Steve and Daphne in beautiful Ottawa, who today are celebrating their wonderful wedding anniversary, and wishing Steve and wonderful wife a happy anniversary, and all the very best from their family and all family, and especially from Mom Rita and all the grandkids. Wishing you the very, very best, guys, hand in hand. of you, your very best, and all your family, to all anyone out there that's celebrating your anniversary, folks, to you fine folks too as well. Beautiful number that was composed by singer-songwriter Dennis Kendall. And in here, beautiful job there, Kevin. Good, great composition. How you doing there, sister-in-law? She got special taps for her shoes. She got those taps all worn off her shoes.
She got sticky shoes on.
Okay.
No, I'm going to heat them.
According to them, have a heat turn back, isn't
it? No.
Yes.
No, it's not.
No, no, okay.
No, it's not. Why?
No, I, yes.
Okay, another birthday.
Okay. Get back to the schedule. We got to do Carolyn and Eugene is tuning in too as well. Guys, we're going to get your number for you momentarily now. Gray foggy day. And you have to silver and gold.
Oh, gosh. I'll make you dance that one.
We like to dedicate this number to our good buddy, Mr. Kelvin Goods. And Kelvin's over on the Darien Peninsula. Anything right now, I'm his family. And this number is called Silver and Gold. Okay, folks, I do a conversation now that was done out by Eddie Coffee, singer-songwriter Eddie Coffee, singer-songwriter Eddie Cotty. Eddie wrote this song called Gray Foggy Day. And we'd like to dedicate this number to our good friends, Eugene and his wonderful wife,
Carol.
Carol, yeah.
Your old buddy Bill Stupid's on there, and Liam.
See?
Yeah.
You?
Liam Littlecock.
Oh,
Liam?
He says there, no question, John. He goes to see Phil Corey and he plays with John on TV.
Oh, I see that.
This close to her. Newfoundland Moss.
Yep.
This used to be Edmund Harris, was it?
Mm-hmm.
And I'd like to say hello to Skipper Mr. Bill Stewart and his wonderful wife Fran and their little grandson Liam. How you doing, little Liam? Buddy, I hope you're playing along, playing the accordion, eh? So, anyway, guys, like to say hello to Bill and Fran, and I hope you guys are doing great, and little Liam also as well. So we're going to do a number now, so I dedicate the number to Bill and his wife and the little grandson, like Penny Murphy died. A little Irish number here for you. Sing it. And, okay. I think someone wanted this particular number last week too, didn't he?
What's that?
Yeah.
Well, that's where I had pretty well the last one down, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Oh, number 64. We have some greens here.
And, okay, folks, we'd like to give a shout out to some fine, fine folks in Brisbane, Searle, S-E-A-R-L-E?
Yeah, Searle.
Okay, from beautiful Norfolk, Virginia, we'd like to give a nice shout out to Ruth and Searle Rayburn. How you doing, guys, in all the beautiful little Norfolk, Virginia, and from the United States. Anyway, guys, thank you for tuning in. Sincerely, we really appreciate that. And take care of yourselves. I'm wishing you fine folks the very, very best. And I'd also like to say hello and thank you, Evelyn and Anthony, for tuning in there. Thank you very much indeed.
That's Mark's friend.
Mark's friend. Oh, yeah. Evelyn, how you doing there? I still didn't know you, but now I know you.
Tell her Mark is here.
Yeah, your friend Mark is here. And she said that if you were here, you'd stomp her right down. Anyway, I wish you the best, huh? And also, all the way from beautiful Calgary, I'd like to say hello to Shirley Beggs. How are you doing, Shirley? And thank you for tuning in there sincerely. And thank you very much indeed. And wishing you the very best, too, as well. And I'd like to say hello to Todd Lake from beautiful Northern Ontario. And Todd is originally from Rochon, Newfoundland, Labrador.
He's working in the mine up there.
And as a matter of fact, Todd is working in the mine up in Northern Ontario. And I'd like to wish him the very, very best, buddy, and take care of yourself. And before too long, Todd, buddy, you'll be home after you finish your shift, for sure. So take care of yourself.
Northern Ontario.
And beautiful Guysborough in there in beautiful Nova Scotia. I'd like to say hello to Ricky Grover. How you doing, Ricky? Thanks for tuning in, buddy. And
I hope that's a lady.
I'm sorry, Ricky. I think it's Ricky. Ricky? Okay, there. Sorry, I got the gender mixed up here. But Ricky, this is an informal show there, I tell you. I get all the blame when I mix up. But anyway, Ricky, thank you for tuning in there. Thank you very much, sincerely. And we'll dedicate a little number called Little Boston Clan to you as well. And our good buddy, Rachel and Michelle. Here's a Little Boston Clan.
Yeah,
well, all
the scales on here.
Yeah, I'd like to say hello to a fantastic accordion player, and he's an icon too as well, as ever will be, because Mr. Wallace Gill. Buddy, how you doing, Wallace? And thank you for tuning in, buddy, and gotta get you on live again sometime, or get some videos going of you playing the accordion. I haven't seen you on there for quite a while now, so anyway, Wallace, wish you the very best, buddy, and keep up the great accordion music that you can play.
Excellent.
Yes. Here's a little note called Little Boston Clan. Roy Payne composition.
When the little boats go out to sea, the shores of Newfoundland, God, do me a favor and guide them with your hand. Protect them from the danger and the furies of the sea. For the little boats of Newfoundland mean the world to me. My mama told me stories when I was just a boy. But those little boats off Newfoundland sometimes made me cry. She told me of the urchins and the dangers of the sea. That God remained until the day I died in my memories. And then she said, that's what they are. Those who face the icy winds, knowing that when you leave their sheltered homes, they never come back again. And then as the teardrops fill my eyes, she held my tiny hand and say, son, the trying to see on this blessed earth are those little boats of Newfoundland. When your little boats go out on the shores of Newfoundland, God, do me a favor and guide them well to your land. Protect them from the dangers and the fears of the sea. For the little boats of Newfoundland mean the world to me. Yes, the little boats of Newfoundland mean the world to me. Composition there, folks, by great singer-songwriter Mr. Roy Payne, the boats of Newfoundland. Okay, folks, we'll speed things up a little bit now, lighten things up a little bit. Do a K-Man Reels. And I'd like to give a shout out to my uncle and aunt in beautiful Grand Falls, Uncle Arlene and Ethel. How are you guys doing today, guys? Hope you're doing great, and wishing you and your friends the very, very best in there. And thanks to Arlene and Ethel for tuning in, guys. And here's the record of the Cape Reel Movie.
Thank you.
They're dancing there, ladies. Yay!
Right, you should drink when you're dancing like that. You should. Have a tea. Some tea make it too hot. I'll have a break.
Okay.
I'm worse than that, Margaret. Ooh. What?
I hope I get myself a tea.
Yes, I just told you what you want. You might have to open the can and knock in the cupboard. The one in the fridge is almost empty.
Okay, folks, I'm doing number now. I got a request to do a number called Newfoundland Lost. And after this one, I'm going to do Heading Home. We do have a lot of requests for Heading Home too as well. Doing number now, we'd like to dedicate to Peggy Regis. Peggy Regis. Peggy, like to hear a number called Newfoundland Lost, composed by singer-songwriter Hedy Compton. Conversation now that was done up by the late great Johnny Drake. Johnny is singer-songwriter, and he wrote this number called Heading Home. And we got a lot of requests for this particular number, and beautiful number indeed. And number that most people like. And we all go on vacation, but the only thing is when we're coming home, we'd love to be home too as well.
The lady on there, Jean Lindsay, she wants rose in her hair, but we don't have that, so just dedicate
that to her. Yeah.
Joan
Lindsay?
Jean.
Jean. And I tell you what, Jean, dear, we don't have the rose in her hair, but tell you what, we'll dedicate the number for you called Hidden Home. And Jean Lindsay, anyway, Jean, sorry, dear, but next week, I guarantee you, we'll get that one on our in our repertoire. Jean, and thank you, dear, much indeed, too, as well.
And for Marion Smith.
And in Nome, too, let's like to dedicate them to Marion Smith, too, as well. For you, Marion, as well, there. In Nome, and beautiful number indeed. And also like to say hello to our good friend, Beverly and Tom Denny. And how you doing tonight, guys? The beautiful St. John's. I hope you guys are doing great. No doubt you are. And wishing you nothing but the very, very best to you and your family. And in Nome. And I also like to say hello to our good buddy, tunes in pretty frequently, Mr. Baxter Gale, and his wonderful wife and family, and heading home too as well. And we'd like to dedicate the number to Mr. Stuart May in Blorm, and beautiful Blorm in Fortune Bay, and to Ann Conlon and
Georgina Penny,
and
Sarah Butler and
Mortair, and Tom and Marie Blaglin, and beautiful Poxy, and to all the fine folks tuning in too as well. And I also like to dedicate the number to my first cousin Joyce Terspiller, and I'd like to dedicate the number in memory to her loving husband Matt. All of her family as well. Yeah, I didn't know.
And to Ann Bella, she, Kim said she, her mom hasn't been on there, so.
No?
She didn't say hi to her.
Yeah, and we'd like to say hello to our good friend from beautiful Comstock, Ann Bellis. And hello, Ann Bellis. Wishing you the very, very best there, and all, and hope you're doing, feeling a little better, and to you and your wonderful family, too, as well.
Roll, Kim.
And also to Roe and Kim too as well, and all the families that are away and all over, folks. So we really appreciate you fine folks tuning in. So we dedicate them to all the fine folks tuning in tonight. In Nome.
Just too much to know.
my own. The roads we are paved, these old fishing schooners are gone. The old church looks the same as it did when I sang in the choir. My spouse gave the news with the lunch on the government board. The new days made way for the pastor and mother's big bones. As you walk to downtown, you know she is sheep cow or goat. There's keepers, no calling, they're a thing of the past. Now it's for the listeners, I think they are changing so fast. My memories may fill me, I feel like a king when I say I'm a proud Newfoundlander from your own in Old Fortune Bay. I need a chauffeur, get down the nearest clear road. There's a lump in my throat, so I know that I'm headed home. When I reach the chest, I know everything is alright. There's just too much to go, I'll be alone tonight. There's just too much to go, I'll be alone. Yes, sir, and I tell you, I'm in St. Jack's now, but I'm on the way to Blorum, and two more months to go, and I'm going to be in Blorum to that Harnstall Festival. Put it beautiful indeed, and fantastic. Heading home, folks. I'd like to put a little plug in now for Lukey's Boat. Myself and my brother-in-law, Jimmy, and Lukey's Boat is going to be performing at the Bedford Legion on November the 12th, folks, the day after our Mistress Day, or Remembrance Day. So anyway, locally, anyone in the area, come on out and let's have a low-down great time at the Bedford Legion on November the 12th.
All the good dancers are going to be there.
Yep, all the dancers are going to be there.
Okay. Wally's going to be there. Hi, Wally.
Is he?
Wally and Marie, how you doing, guys? Part of the gang is going to be there. Wilmore and Judy. Yep. Helen Cox and Mildred, yep,
for sure. Okay.
Well, the buddy is on here from Ireland, Kevin O'Neill. Wow.
And I'd like to say hello to Mr. Kevin O'Neill from beautiful Ireland. What part of Ireland is he on? Galway Bay?
Galway, yeah.
Galway?
Yeah.
Hello, Kevin. Thanks for tuning in, buddy, from beautiful Galway and our beautiful Ireland. And thank you very much indeed for tuning in.
1:30 over there now.
1:30 over there now? Yeah, wow. Okay. Okay. We'd like to dedicate, we have a request now to do for Anita Earl and George Wicks. And Anita wants to do a number, called Don't Be Angry. So we're going to a special dedication to Anita Earl and her friend George Wicks. And there's a traditional great Hank Wayu senior number, Don't Be Angry. And we'll dedicate this number to our Irish friend too as well, Kevin O'Neill. And we'll have a special one later on for
from as well, a little more Irish.
Okay, what number is that now? We'll be angry. 33. Can hear myself sometimes.
If I fail to understand all your little whims and wishes all the time, just remember that I've done my gifts like any foolish man, and my hitch days so the foggy cause you're mine. The first time that I'm flirting with you, dear, when I jokingly said, come and be my bride. Now the time has turned the pages, it's the sweetest joke on earth, that I had you, dear, forever by my side. Bye. Come on, George. Dance around, buddy. Need us to catch up.
Pearl.
Oh, Pearl, yeah. Watch the needle. Maybe someday you're gonna hurt me. Am I hurting up before the work? Only God can know, and time alone will tell. In the meantime, I'll be loving you with all my heart and soul. And pray God that it lasts if it's His will. Don't be angry with me, darling, if I fail to understand all your little wish and wishes all the time. Just remember that I've done my gifts like any foolish man, and my hitch days so foggy.
Beautiful number there, folks. Don't be angry with me, darling. Real nice romantic number there for sure.
It's a nice song. It's a nice song. Some guy once lost up to Marion, but I don't think he got that.
No. Wow.
His name is Kevin Kennedy.
Kevin Kennedy. How you doing, Kevin, buddy? Thanks for tuning in, pal.
Yes,
and,
from North here.
Kevin Kennedy, are you from North here, buddy? And let the wife know.
She's from Foxhole.
Wife's from Foxhole. And her sister from Foxhole. But anyway, Kevin, buddy, we don't have that one available tonight but in our playlist, but I'll tell you what, Lost in Marion, a conversation with Mr. Bud Davies, we're going to do for you next week. And we'll mark that one down for sure. Okay. We want to do a number now. Call the rat in the rotter cage.
Oh my gosh. All right? That's a hard one. That's
a
hard one.
Okay, let me switch off. Let me see what we got here.
That's John McDonald's song. John McDonald used to like that. John McDonald. He got it. Yeah.
Thank you.
say that my brother Jerry was putting the runs in that particular number, the guitar licks in that one there. And I think that number there I heard, I think the first I heard in the tune was Mr. Ray Johnson. Ray Johnson is one of his numbers that he used to play years ago called Rat in the Birdcage.
Yeah. Okay, bye. A lot of stuff here.
Oh, yeah. I've seen her today. All right. Super soft. They're going to give them a weekend treat. Liquor store. Oh, that was Halloween treats. And, the weekend special. Oh, is that nobody home?
No.
Oh. If somebody wants nobody home.
Oh, ended up there, aren't you?
And it's his birthday.
Okay.
We're doing such a day.
Standing alone in the shadow, I'll sail on the bay. Glad you're doing number now, folks, to the fantastic accordion player up in New Brunswick, Mr. Roger Letang. And this is one of his compositions here, or one of his numbers that he usually does. I heard him play this particular number some time ago.
Some liquid. Right, say hi to Rita. Say hi, Mark.
Hi, Rita.
And
hi, Rita.
Rita's girls are doing crafts tonight.
Hello, Rita. How are you doing tonight, Darren? I hope you're doing great tonight.
Have a wine for me.
Okay, I'll be in there.
What? She come over to play? Probably, I don't know for sure.
Some folks regret the long tonight. never thrill to the feeling that a lonely brings until it's too late and they are ready to lie down. They're only beneath the leaves that scattered on the ground.
Say hello to Mr. Bill Dominey. Happy birthday, Bill, buddy. Virgil Bill. That's his Facebook profile picture. Bill, Mr. Bill Dominey. How you doing, buddy? Happy birthday to you, Bill. And wishing you the very, very best, buddy. Happy birthday to you on behalf of Nana and all your family. And also like to wish the grandson of Anithia Carroll, Stephen Dunley, and Randy, yeah. Happy birthday, Stephen, to you, buddy, and wishing you the very, very best and to that. And happy birthday to you, Stephen, as well, pal. And wishing everyone in Randy the very, very best, folks. And I'm sure that you'd like to tuning in to Mr. George Jaws and Mr. Rob Pink. They're an awesome couple and musicians. They do a great job tonight, folks, and they're on there tonight, too, as well. So, anyway, happy birthday, guys, and we're going to wish you happy birthday, no? Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday, dear Bill and Stephen. Happy birthday to you, many, many more, guys. All the best to you.
Happy birthday, Bill.
Where
does he get
to? And Stephen.
And then we have a Todd Richards on the other name, Carol's son.
Okay. So we have, we're going to do this one later on for Gerald and Gertie, Strawberries from Whiteco. We will search for Danny, and we're going to get to that one pretty soon, Gerald and Gertie. up there, son. And also, we got, we're going to do Nobody Home, Nobody's Home for Bill and Stephen. And also, Nobody Home for Liz Malashki. I'm sorry, Liz, who is celebrating her 93rd birthday on November the 5th. Liz Malashki. I'm sorry I'm doing injustice to your last name, darling, but Liz, wishing you a happy 93rd birthday on November the 5th. And that's from Peggy Regis. Anyway, darling, 93 years young, and Liz will be celebrating your birthday. And you want to hear a number called Nobody Home. Well, okay. Nobody Home by Mr. Peter Jacobs.
Oh my God, yes, sir, on birthday.
And this is going to be 93 years young on November the 5th. And we're going to sing Liz now. We're going to sing her happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Liz. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, darling. And I tell you, I've pronounced your last name, but I don't want to do any injustice more than I've done. But Liz, dear, happy birthday to you, and wishing you the very, very best from your family.
Oh, it's from Peggy, isn't it?
Yeah, from Peggy Regis, yeah.
Okay, okay.
To Liz and your family. So for you, we're going to do the number that's composed by singer-songwriter Peter Jacobs, Nobody Home.
Where
composition there, folks, by Mr. Peter Jacobs. Peter Jacobs, your number is called Nobody Home. Great, great indeed. Wonderful.
Beautiful song, isn't it? He's a good singer, isn't he?
Oh, yeah.
That sounds nice with the chord, you know. You're all so I know, true words, yeah.
Okay. I'd like to do a number now, folks, that was composed by singer-songwriter Mr. Angus Stewart. And as a matter of fact, I had a chance to jam with Angus and meet him over at a great private gig we had for Ann McCullough. And all of her sons and all of her families and friends and relatives were there. And Angus is an awesome musician and singer-songwriter, and originally from Ramia, and he's composed a whole lot of numbers that he even hasn't got a chance to be heard yet. So anyway, Angus composed this number, and that's made popular by a lot of groups like Shirley Canook, and he composed a number called Rockin' on Wire. Man, that man can write a song when he's talking to you. So anyway, here's a number called Rockin' on Water. And I'd like to dedicate the number to Ann McCullough and all of her friends and family and who came out that that afternoon. And always a pleasure to have the opportunity to play for Ann and all her friends and family. So here's an Angus Stewart number called Rockin' on Water.
Yeah.
and through my shoulders and left my room late. I swear, hope you're out on the ocean. You don't know the Newfoundland. When we're rocking on the water, make a little bit of harbor back in Newfoundland. Great conversation there, folks. Fantastic, by Mr. Haynes Stewart.
Okay, here we go. We got people that can do it. Both ways to talk. That's fine.
Yeah, somebody just asked for that. Lorraine Morris, M-R-I-S. Say hi to Frida. Hi, Frida.
Frida Hittich?
Yeah.
I'd like to say and give a shout out to Frida Hittich, Frida and Dave. How are you guys doing tonight, guys? And we're going to see you guys down in the beautiful Skeleton in the latter part of November. Folks, so anyway, you guys take it easy and we'll see you then down in beautiful Skeleton. And who's the lady you begin with that?
Lorraine Morris.
And there's a number, a beautiful number that we get a lot of requests for Lorraine Morse and the Butterflies Could Talk. This is a number that was composed by Lister Martin.
Yeah.
Lister Martin. Yep. Lister Martin composed this particular number, and I think his grandson Jason. The one who did the recording, eh? He recorded in the studio.
Not a grandson.
No, his nephew. His nephew, sorry, Jason. And Lester's Jazz. Nephew, Jason.
And, we can drink some water.
Butterfly, you're drunk. Butterflies could talk.
No, I had some lost it up.
Some water.
Oh, my.
Sometimes in this life, there's song and there's pain, and when we lose someone, it'll never be the same. But I know that they are signs sent down from up above to let us loved ones know they're sending down their love. Then butterflies could talk. with your memory to me, and I won't be afraid, for I know that you're okay. The butterflies could come, I know what they will say. Golden shore, my loved ones I will meet, and be with them forevermore. Let not your heart be sad, think of me every day, and when you see that sign, you know that I'm okay. Butterflies could talk, and if pennies they could see, if I need a gun with your memories to me, then I won't be afraid. I know that you're okay. If butterflies, I know what they would say. If butterflies could talk, they say that you're okay.
Beautiful conversation there, folks, by Mr. Lister Martin.
What chopper breakdown, you know? I learned I gotta get that for next week.
You do some good on
raspberry.
Oh, no, I love that. Yeah. You just had to learn that.
What raspberry?
Yeah, we don't have that on for tonight.
No, I paid twice, didn't I?
That was last week.
Try to keep it in. Okay.
Flight 59, folks, and I'd like to dedicate the note to Mr. Paul Hamilton and Hamilton Sound, all the boys in the band, and Nate Hammond and Linda Hickey, and all the fine guys. They do a great, great job, and they're pretty busy playing their circuit and all over the place, and they do a great job. It's a number called the Flight 59, and this is a number for Linda Hickey and all the gang in the Hamilton Sound Band. Thank you. fantastic.
Okay. Really? What time?
Okay. Okay, the guitar. The guitar work.
Well, it's guitar time.
Okay, folks, right now I'd like to slow things down and do a conversation that's done up by Mr. Lloyd Snow. And Lloyd Snow is an awesome, awesome musician and a great, great vocalist and a fantastic country singer. And actually, everyone, we're all glad that when Lloyd can get up and play the music he loves playing. Lloyd is an awesome performer, like I said. So let's do one of these conversations now called Down East Country Boy. Down East Boy. Down East Boy like me. This morning, they found me eastward bound. I'll be taking all that I can take, the steady life I found. I'm headed back to places that I know are great to me. See, life's what kind of life. Down East Boy like me. I traveled west to Hendon, then south to New Orleans. And the folks back home would not believe some places I have seen. I spent some time in my field with the Lord there. Plus, city life, no kind of life, but a Downey's boy like me. I need to feel the green grass growing underneath my feet. I need to watch the sunset as I walk along the beach. I need to feel the morning breeze when it blows in from the sea. See life, no kind of life, a Downey's boy like me. Sun goes down on my own town, on the miles and miles away. I swear this time when I get back, that's where I'm going to stay. Tomorrow you will find me in my home down by the sea. Cause sea life, no kind of life. Downey's boy like me. I need to feel the green grass growing underneath my feet. I need to watch the sun.
sunset as I wandered on the beach. I need to feel the morning breeze that blows in from the sea. See life will kind of die for a county's boy like me. City lights, no kind of night, a townie's boy like me. Composition here, folks, by Mr. Lloyd Snow, singer-songwriter, Mr. Lloyd Snow, a townie's boy like me. Great, great composition. Here's a whole familiar number, folks, from down yonder. Dedication to Gerald and Gertie Strawbees from our neighboring community, Rickton. And Gerald and Gertie want to hear a number called Who Will Search for Daddy? And we're going to get that number for you now, guys. Who Will Search for Daddy?
You want a set trip?
Yeah, 79. Okay, folks, I can do this number now. This number was composed by my good buddy and singer-songwriter, Mr. late and great Mr. Ray Richards. And Ray wrote a song based on a true story about this ranger who got lost in a blinding snowstorm. So this is for Gerald and Gertie. the Isle of Newfoundland, not knowing what they bring you, cost the same. You got posted down in Liverpool, the Isle of Rocky Shore, to our friend on and over to the land. Though some of them were strange, not knowing they were in a helping hand. Who will search for Danny? His mother, she cried. He left here on that mountain all alone. The spirit's almost gone. Help someone bring my Betty home back home. He tried to cross that mountain on that cold frosty day. Who was that friend down on the other side? Got lost down in the valley as the night was coming on. Sat down in the snow and started to cry. Spirit's almost gone. Will someone bring my daddy back home? Who will search for Danny, folks? Very sad number indeed, based on a true story.
not young as we used to be. We're not young like we used to be.
And we'd like to give a nice shout out to our good friend, Alice Combs. How you doing, Alice? And Alice Combs O'Keefe, yeah. And how you doing there? And glad you're tuning in. And then see, Alice got her own own program, her own
radio show,
yeah. And does a great, great job. And thanks all the fine local artists. And does a great, great job indeed. Anyway, Alice, you take care there and keep up the great, great music. You're doing a wonderful job. And promoting the little guy as well, so it's fantastic. Fantastic.
Did that one really tear it off to midnight, or I don't know how many choices now.
Kick off at green is 35.
Mm-hmm. I can't see me without you. What's that one?
Oi.
Why? Sorry about that. I've had choice. Since the day that I was born, there were voices that told me right from wrong. If I had listened, no, I wouldn't be here today, living and dying with the choices I made. I was tempted. By an early age I found I liked dreaming, all but never turned it down. There were enough ones, but I turned them all away. I'm living and dying with the choices I made. I've had choices since the day that I was born. There were voices that told me right from wrong. If I had listened, no, I wouldn't be here today, living and dying with the choice that I made. I guess I'm paying for the things that I have done. If I could go back, oh Lord knows I run, but I'm still losing this game of life I play, losing and dying with the choice as I made. I had choices since the day that I was born. There were voices that told me right from wrong. If I had listened, no, I wouldn't be here today, living and dying with the choices I made.
Nice. Okay, the number's 87.
Okay.
And the other one you wanted was 35.
There's a beautiful number here, folks, entitled I Can't See Me Without You. Is it day or is it night? Am I losing my sight? Is it over? Are we really good? I can't see you in my arms anymore. I can't see me without you. I can't see me without you. No, I can't see you leaving or gone. I could never see anything you wanted me to. I can't see me without you. Doing number now, folks, and time Henley's J. remember that was made popular by an awesome musician, late great singing Savory, a fantastic accordion player, and awesome recording and artist too as well. Guitar player? Yes, for the English chick. Jake, folks, thank you very much.
You left them there.
Tell me about meeting and friends.
I'm going to do it now. Do a lesson.
Okay. This guy wants you to send a hello to his brother in Ontario. Just a hi.
Meet your friends. Who did you say?
Oh, it's over there. It's from his brother, Kevin.
Going to Terry and Dip?
Yeah.
From brother Kevin, okay.
And now, Kevin like to... must do a request for Terry and Debbie Kennedy in Cambridge, Ontario. And so this is for Terry and Debbie from Kevin, right?
Yeah.
To Terry and Debbie Kennedy from Kevin, and Terry and Debbie lives in Cambridge, Ontario. And there's another call, Music and Friends, for you fine folks. So folks, thank you very much for tuning in tonight, and we sincerely thank you for making our show what it is. And we have a lot of fun, it's very informal, and just play a little bit of music, and hopefully that we read some of the music that you find folks enjoy, and we don't do this every Friday night to get all the numbers in, but we try the best we can, and what we don't get in, we try to carry over the following Friday. So. Anyway, folks, take care of yourselves out there, and thank you for tuning in. And like I said, Monday is Halloween for the kids, right?
No, Wednesday.
Wednesday? Wednesday Halloween? You sure?
Okay.
Monday?
Monday. Okay, Monday.
Monday, yeah. Monday is Halloween for the kids out there. And everyone, folks, extra caution and take care and make sure our kids are safe. So, anyway, folks, until next week, God bless and thank you very much. So here's a conversation by singer-songwriter Mr. Bud Davies. To all you fine folks, nothing like music and friends. And I'd like to thank my wonderful sister-in-law, Mary, for coming over and making a great evening of dancing. And right now, we have to redo our floors over again, but that's okay. She's a great dancer. And my wife, Karina, for stepping in and reminding me of some of the numbers. Old age creeping up, right?
That's okay.
And good night. Take care of yourselves. Until next Friday, God bless. Thank you.
Good night.